Hallelujah.
A strong sense of destiny will be released in you. So there are five key elements of destiny that will begin to flow out of your life. Number one, discipline. A God-given purpose produces discipline. Are you hearing me, somebody? I said a God-given purpose produces discipline. Why does it produce discipline? Because it challenges you to fulfill what the Creator has created you for.
Amen.
I said it challenges you to fulfill what the Creator has created you for. I'll say it again. A God-given purpose produces discipline. This God-given purpose will challenge you. It will make you uncomfortable. How many know that discipline makes you uncomfortable?
Yes. Amen.
It will make you uncomfortable. It will remind you that you need to be doing this and you don't need to be doing that.
Amen. That's right.
No one has to tell you.
That's right.
Your purpose will start talking to you.
Oh God.
The spirit of the purpose of God, this God-given purpose, will speak to you and tell you, stop it.
Amen. That's right.
Stop hanging around. You know better.
Amen.
It will tell you, do this. Do that. It will encourage you. You can do this. You can do this.
Amen.
I believe in you. You can do this. It will speak to you because it will challenge you to fulfill its purpose for the very reason why God created you. This is why discipline is released for a God-given purpose. When you know where God wants you to go, then you don't want to do anything that will get you off course.
Amen.
It produces a healthy discipline. Now, it's very important for you to understand when it comes down to discipline, it's easily said, it's easy to pronounce it, it's easy to say it, it's easy to have conversations about it. It's easy to spell it. It's easy to define it. It's easy to look up a definition of it. You understand? It's easy even to preach it and teach it.
Yes, sir.
But it's very challenging to do.
Amen.
And so therefore, it's something to meditate on. You got to prepare your mind and your soul, which is your mind, your will, and your emotions, to be disciplined. You got to say, I'm going to do this. But you know, you don't just jump on no weights, or you just don't all of a sudden say, oh, I'm going to the health club today. Let me pull up the parking lot. I'm going in. And I'm going to start working out. It don't work like that. Do about 60 push-ups and 150 jumping jacks, and you getting on the treadmill just because you just decided to. Oh no, most individuals, they may decide to and go in the parking lot and sit about 15, 20, 30 minutes and say, do I want to do this? Am I ready for this? Let me go around and just look around the place first. You understand what I'm saying? You just don't jump on a diet because you decided I want to jump on a diet. No, you think about it. You got to prepare your mind. You got to prepare your body and your spirit to discipline yourself. Huh? Even a wise parent just don't jump up and say, you know, I'm going to discipline this child. No, they want to discipline. There's a difference between a whooping and discipline.
Amen.
Because discipline is for the upbringing and building up of character. A woman in office is going to beat you down like a slave. You shouldn't have been it. Turn around, boy. You understand what I'm saying?